The Telangana stir has intensified with activists and police clashing at Indira Park in Hyderabad. Meanwhile, the news that's just coming in is that the Ranga Reddy District Court has admitted a petition against former Home Minister P. Chidambaram and the current Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde. Now, this PIL has accused them of cheating the people of Telangana with their statements. The court has directed the police to register a case. A Telangana Rashtra Samiti, meanwhile, is leading a 36-hour relay strike from today. The Telangana Joint Action Committee has decided to pressurize ministers and MPs of the Congress Party. But let's talk to CNNIBN's Preeti Singh in Hyderabad for the very latest. Preeti, first of all, confirm to us that indeed a case is now being registered against the former Home Minister Chidambaram and the current Home Minister Shinde for quote-unquote cheating the people of Telangana.
Ananya, for now, the Rangareddy District Court, like we've mentioned, has admitted a petition that was filed by a Junior Advocates Association. Now, remember, this court also falls under the Telangana region. The junior advocates here belonging to the Telangana region putting in a petition accusing the former Home Minister Chidambaram and current Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde of cheating Telangana people. They say in their petition, they have mentioned that statements such as those made by Mr. Chidambaram on 9th December 2009 and more recently by Mr. Sushil Kumar Shinde have raised hope of Telangana people about a separate state, and they feel cheated. Now, the court has directed the police to register a case of 420, which is that of cheating against the two ministers. And for now, though, the police saying that they will wait for the court orders, really. Remember, this has happened just about a few minutes ago at the Rangareddy court. So, yes, the court admitting a petition and directing the police to register a case against the former Home Minister Chidambaram and the current Home Minister Sushil Kumar Shinde.
All right, so the court has asked the police register a case against the former Home Minister and the current Home Minister based on this PIL that's been filed, which accuses them of cheating the people of Telangana with their statements promising the formation of the state, and yet there's a delay in announcing that decision. Preeti, also, as far as the agitation is concerned, what's the scene at the moment in Hyderabad and neighbouring areas?
Ananya, for now, the protests are continuing at the protest venue, which is Indira Park in the capital city of Hyderabad. There are protesters who have been sitting here since about yesterday. Remember, it was a 36-hour call, protest call that was given yesterday that concludes today at 6 p.m. But right now, the demand really getting louder for resignation of Congress legislators from Telangana region. The protesters here, including the legislators of other parties like TRS, demanding that Congress legislators from Telangana, be it the MPs or MLAs, resigned from the party and thus build pressure on the Congress to come out with a quick decision on Telangana. In fact, even as we speak, the Congress MPs from Telangana are meeting to discuss really how best they can tackle the situation. Remember, this, the postponement of deadlines really coming as huge embarrassment for Congress party members here in the state.
Preeti, anything specific that we're hearing from the Telangana Rashtra Samiti?
So now, Ananya, they are saying, most of them, including the TRS and the Telangana Joint Action Committee, both of them saying that they are really looking at a political battle. They are not really clear about a clear-cut strategy that they want. They are saying they will come up with it by tonight or latest by tomorrow, where they will have a two-pronged approach. One is that of continuing protest, and the other is really of putting pressure, political pressure, on the Congress by maybe getting the Telangana legislators from Congress on board along with them.
All right, Preeti Singh is getting us those details then from Hyderabad about the stir that's continuing in Hyderabad itself regarding the delay in the union government's announcement of a decision on Telangana. Preeti, thanks very much. Just listen in to the reactions we're getting from political parties.
I'm not only disappointed, I think it is not that easy for me to swallow. Simply is, people have lost faith now, the credibility. People are in no mood to believe this because they have suffered. Once bitten, twice shy. So they think the party is trying to buy time, is a tactic to buy time, and then they are not prepared. They must go out and get it in whatever the manner.
Yesterday's decision by the Congress High Command, another delay being announced. How is the pro-Telangana party, such as yours, reacting to it?
Once again, Congress party cheated the people of Telangana. It looks like that they doesn't want to form Telangana statehood. So it looks, since 2004, they are again and again postponing the issue. They said that they want some more consultations. How long you will consult? Definitely in the coming days, we will intensify the hesitation over the Congress party and the state government.